Older homes give our communities character. But if you're an owner of an older home made with bricks or concrete blocks, you need to take some steps to help your home keep its character and survive an earthquake. Before the 1970s, home building standards were not as strict as they are today. Homes built before then with bricks or concrete blocks and mortar weren't designed to resist strong earthquake forces. Typically, the roof and floor systems weren't attached to walls as securely as they are now. Walls themselves didn't have the needed reinforcement. Homes built this way are referred to as unreinforced masonry buildings, or URMs for short. When earthquakes strike, walls fail, homes shift off their foundations, and chimneys collapse. There are fixes that can be made that'll keep all this together. Let me introduce you to Burke Hills. He's a contractor with experience in making URM homes safer. Hi, Burke.
Hi.
So, Burke, what are you doing here?
We are doing a seismic upgrade to this home. We're working on the roof-to-wall connections and also bracing the chimney. What this will do is it will make this house less likely to collapse in the event of an earthquake.
When you're doing these repairs or these upgrades, how do you know what to fix?
There's a structural engineer that has designed this work for this house, and he has given us the details of what needs to be done to make this house safer. And we know how to do that kind of work, and we take care of it.
So if I'm a homeowner and I'm trying to decide when a good time is to do this kind of work, what would you tell me?
Well, there's always a good time to do it, but it's probably more economical if you were going to re-roof your house, say. That would be a great time to also do the seismic upgrade at the same time.
Getting your URM home strengthened doesn't guarantee it won't suffer damage in an earthquake. But with walls and roof firmly anchored together and the chimney braced, there's less chance of collapse and the injuries that would follow. Audrey Pierce manages a financial grant program that helps people pay for upgrades.
As we started talking to people, we found that they did have some barriers to getting the work done, in that they either were unsure of how to get started or they didn't realize just how unstructured their unreinforced masonry home was. And then as they would try to get bids on how much it was going to cost them, then they ran into money barriers as far as getting the work done. So when we found the way as a city to be able to help provide some of that to them, we've now got a list of people that are getting the work done and a list of people that are waiting to get the work done.
Let's meet Ryan. He's the homeowner. So, Ryan, what do you tell somebody when they say something like, I can't afford to do this kind of work?
It is a little expensive, but when you take into account safety, I don't know that you can really put a price tag on safety. You know, older homes need a lot of repair, and this is kind of one more repair that needs to be done.
Good on you, Ryan, for making your home safer. Take 20 minutes to research when your brick or concrete block home was constructed. The title to your house should have that information, or you can find out from your county clerk. Then take another 20 minutes to find a contractor experienced in making homes safer in case of an earthquake. Thanks for watching.
Visit kbyutv.org to get your free 20 to Ready emergency preparedness guide.